Britain also taking further measures against Russia. The UK has banned any British entity from undertaking transactions with Russia's central bank, finance ministry, and wealth fund. The new sanctions also prevent Russian companies from issuing transferable securities and money market instruments in the UK. As the world tightens its financial squeeze on Russia, the nation is now scrambling to manage the broadening fallout. On Monday, the Russian central bank raised its key interest rate from 9.5% to 20% to counter risks of ruble depreciation and higher inflation. Moscow also ordered companies to sell 80% of their foreign currency revenues. The central bank has likewise announced a slew of measures to support domestic markets. These include increasing the range of securities it can be used as collateral to get loans. The bank also said it would resume buying gold on the domestic market. Moscow vows to impose retaliatory sanctions on the West. Kremlin spokesperson Dmitry Peskov admits sanctions imposed by the West would likely cause problems for Russia. But he asserts Russia has reduced its dependency on foreign imports to protect itself against the threat of sanctions. He did not say what sanctions would be imposed against the West. Panic grips Russians as new Western sanctions hit banks in the country. On Sunday, Russians lined up outside ATMs, fearing new sanctions will trigger shortages of cash and disrupt payment systems in Moscow. The moves to block some Russian banks from the SWIFT global payment system and freeze the Bank of Russia's reserves are expected to deal a severe economic blow. But Russian authorities and lenders are trying to ease fears of any major upheaval. Russia's biggest lender says it's not seeing any interruptions in customer transactions through its own and partner payment systems. BP is abandoning its stake in Russian oil giant Rosneft in an abrupt and costly end to three decades of operations in the energy-rich country. More in this report.
BP is offloading its 20% stake in Russian oil giant Rosneft due to the crisis in Ukraine. It's one of the first major moves by a big company after the invasion, and it's a rapid, costly end for BP to nearly three decades of operating in Russia. Losing Rosneft means BP loses around half of its oil and gas reserves, and the British company says it will take a financial hit of up to $25 billion. In a Sunday statement, BP chief executive Bernard Looney said, quote, "I have been deeply shocked and saddened by the situation unfolding in Ukraine, and my heart goes out to everyone affected. It has caused us to fundamentally rethink BP's position with Rosneft." Looney and his predecessor Bob Dudley will both step down from the board of Rosneft. BP is Russia's biggest foreign investor, and its move puts a spotlight on other Western companies with operations there, including France's Total Energies and Britain's Shell. It also underscores growing pressure from Western governments on companies to cut back Russian operations. Russian news agencies reported that Rosneft have blamed BP's decision on, quote, unprecedented political pressure. Also on Sunday, Alphabet and its YouTube unit were told by a top EU official to ban users pushing war propaganda as part of measures to put a stop to disinformation about Ukraine. Alphabet already barred RT and other Russian state media from getting money from ads on their websites and YouTube channels.